Data plans aren't cheap, and unfortunately, Wi-Fi isn't everywhere yet. But some apps get overeager when they open a network connection, so we decided to give users a way to fight off apps that are literally costing them money. With API 24, we're expanding on a previous feature that allowed users to block background network access for a given app. Now, users can put the entire device into datasaver mode, which will restrict any background activity on metered internet connections until the device is safely on Wi-Fi. DataSaver is easy to trigger so that users can turn it on and off as they see fit. And where users previously only had a blacklist of apps that could no longer use network data in the background, now they can restrict the entire device and then whitelist the few exceptions they wish to allow. The effects of the expanded DataSaver mode are largely unchanged from the previous background restrictions feature. These restrictions only apply to background jobs, since foreground services are generally something the user has requested. And since this is all about saving data, these restrictions only apply when you're on a metered connection, not when you're on unmetered Wi-Fi. But the other major improvement for developers is that we have created an API to check whether your app is currently restricted. This allows you to build better behaviors into your app so that the user understands what data is needed and how it will be used when they ask your app to do something while it is restricted. For example, let's say your app wants to sync with your server. Before, you would simply kick off a background task and hope for the best. But now that you can check whether your network access has been restricted, your background work patterns have shifted. An obvious solution is to identify any network connections you are making that are not time sensitive. Your app should always be data conscious, and these moments are a great opportunity to only sync when on Wi-Fi. If you'd rather not manage this on your own, I recommend Job Scheduler. You can schedule your sync to take place as soon as Wi-Fi is available, and you won't have to worry about it again. Now, if your use case is time sensitive or has some other need to do work on a metered connection, you'll want to check if DataSaver is active for your app. It's a pretty simple method: git restrict background status, and the result will let you know whether DataSaver is currently on, whether it is on and you've been whitelisted, or whether apps have free reign over network connections right now. Checking that status might look a little something like this in your app. If the only network available is a metered network, we need a switch statement to determine the best behavior for our app. Although, again, if you can afford to always wait for Wi-Fi, you should use Job Scheduler and avoid having to know anything about the network connection at all. Check out the links in the description for how to set up a broadcast receiver to listen for signals for a DataSaver state change, how to request the user whitelist your app, and how to test DataSaver with the help of ADB. Because there's always so much more to learn about being data conscious. In general, though, there are a number of good and bad behaviors your app may be doing when it comes to network use. The rule of thumb is to respect that data is expensive and honor the user's preferences when they are trying to be conscientious. It's their device, and your app is a small part of it. We want to empower users to know what their device is doing, and that means app developers sometimes need to work a bit harder. But we've tried to make it easy for you, so now it's your turn to make it easy for users as you build better apps.